Hello, welcome to the Bailey Minute. I'm your host, Brooke Ahana Bailey, and I'm just polishing up a pair of fabulous new boots that I picked up today. These are made in Italy. I did get two, a pair, and I'm just adding a little bit of a nice clear shoe polish to them just to give them that kind of a protective layer because it's going to rain this weekend and I might have to wear my new boots. These I can't sell. Sorry, folks. Maybe eventually down the road I'll be able to part with them, but they fit so good, and they're really a funky look. They look really good with my long, fabulous Indian dress that I got at the flea market at the Fairfax Melrose Trading Post a couple weeks ago. I really love this. It's a little big on me, but with rolling the sleeves up, it really works, and it gives me a chance to don some of my favorite turquoise rings that I collect. And this is kind of a cool piece of ivory, I believe. I don't know. I found this at the market too. What a find. Anyway, we're here today because I wanted to do another project. I had some success with the last one where I antiqued with some shellac, some amber colored shellac, a mirror. I'll show you that. Just one second. Just as a little recap, I thought everybody should see how that turned out. Can you see that? Anyway, so I went ahead and shellacked that. I've still got to do the backs of the shells because I like a completed project, and I think that's going to look really good. Today, I picked up a lamp, and I got it for really low price, like single digits, and came with this shade. And the shade was a bit distracting because it was ugly. I like the shape of it, but it's just not a clean looking shade, which even that's not horrible, but there's a lot of things that you can do to shades to kind of change their look. I remember when I was a little girl, my mom used to do fabulous feathers. She would start, I believe, well, it doesn't matter, I think probably in the bottom, she'd start and she just covered the whole thing with feathers. It looked like bird's wings. It was wonderful with real natural brown, black feathers. It was really fun. But I'm going to try something a little different. I've got a really neat collection of very small black and white old vintage photos. Looks like somebody went on a fabulous skiing trip to Banff, which is up in Canada, and Sun Valley. And I thought, what a fun way to do like a camp look and have these kind of fun ski pictures immersed in some jute twine, which I'm going to wrap around the shade. So this is the first time I've actually done a project start to finish on camera. So bear with me, folks. We might have to do some editing on this one. We don't usually do a lot of editing, so this will be a bit of an experiment for all of us. Okay, I already can tell I don't have my scissor handy, so that'll be interesting. So my dilemma was, do I just tie it and just start going around? But I'm worried about putting twine on this, even if it's jute twine, on the back because of getting hot. I know we're using a lot of better bulbs these days that don't get that hot, but still, I want the shade to work for anybody. So give me one second, I'm gonna grab a scissor wherever I left that in the house. Oh, there it is, I've got it. We may not have to cut after all. I'm gonna cut it off, I tied it on back, but I've decided instead, and it'll be easier for me and probably go quicker for you folks watching at home, if I use my hot glue gun. Every person that's creative, oh, this is gonna be hysterical, I can just already tell. How do I find the end of my ball of twine? Let me count my ways. Okay, if I wasn't on camera. Okay, first of all, hold the phone. Let me just put, I can just tell. I'm using hot glue, I'm wearing my new favorite fabulous dress, and that spells disaster. Can't have that. I just can't have it. So I'm gonna wear one, gives me the opportunity to wear one of my fabulous selvedge denim aprons. Just give that a nice cinch in back. And also a place to put my scissors so I don't have to constantly be looking for them. So I don't have a lot of patience today. We're just gonna cut that off, right? How about that? Okay. Oh, I just hate the fact that I have to put glue gun on the outside. No, I don't. I'm gonna just tuck it underneath here, right? We wanna hide stuff like that. So this should be nice and hot. So I'm gonna start my, right here. Now folks, when you're using a glue gun, you've gotta be particularly careful. Look, I already glue gunned my finger. That's nice. You gotta be particularly careful because it's hotter than hey hooey. And this is a good time to have like a popsicle stick or a little, some sort of a little tool. use the back of my scissor and probably regret it later. I'll use this side because it'll peel off that plastic handle later. So I've got my first, and it's going to take a while. I guess this isn't as fast drying as I'd like it to be. So this isn't going to be where the bulb is, which is nice because I don't want to give any chance for danger. We don't want to have a fire here with all our lovely flea finds. That would be just sickening, wouldn't it? Okay, so now that I've got a starting place, I've got to decide, how am I going to string this? Do I want to just go kind of haphazardly, like around, real random? Do I want to make a real pattern? Do I want to go up and down? Well, I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to do those pictures. Up and down seems like it might work, but I won't be able, I'll have to stop it each time because I don't want to wrap it around. So instead, I'm going to go like this, horizontally. And I'm hoping, oh my gosh, it's going to be completely obnoxious. I think with a round thing, it would work better. We may have to cut. I may have to work some magic behind the scenes and come back and show you how it turns out, because right now it's going to make me crazy. And we don't want to see me. Do we want to see me lose my cool on camera? That could be a whole different show, right? Finally get some hits. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. What have I got myself into? You know what? I might just go a little crazy and just put the flipping glue gun here and there on the front. What can I lose? I mean, I can pick up another silly little shade. It's not like this was the selling point of the whole lamp. What I liked about the lamp is that it's this kind of nice old iron look. Okay. So there you go. I've done the deed. I've actually put glue gun on the front. It's the last thing that I thought I would do. The last. But I think I just need to get a base going a little bit here. So I'm just going to do a tidbit. Try real hard not to let it... Oh, you know what I should tell you guys? This is nothing too genius. I'm no Martha Stewart, as I've said before. I just laid a little wax paper down, though. I was just so pleased I had it because I was making like macaroons or something. Had to have parchment for that, or not parchment, wax paper. And what a good way. I was going to use newspaper, but then I hate how your glue gun's always sticking to that stuff. So this is a nice little save. I mean, the glue doesn't even stick to it. How perfect is that? So I guess if you were doing a project and you wanted to use wax paper, glue gun wouldn't be the perfect glue to use with the wax. Okay, so we're getting started. This clearly is a project that I will have to tell you some other stories. So today, while we're doing this, let's see if I can talk and glue at the same time. There's a challenge. Can't even do the... I might forget about that. Today, I did kind of a big junking session with a dear friend of mine. We both have dogs. I have one, she has three. We left the dogs at her place. There's no story in that. They were really good, thank heavens. They actually all get along good. It's a nice little pack. And it's also like peace of mind for us because we know we can be out basically all day and their dogs are doing fine all together. Very cute. So we decided to start the day with some nourishing crepes. Nice salmon crepe for me with capers. It's like two meals with capers within 12 hours. That's what we had. I don't know if you saw the episode where I did the shellacked mirror. But that night I made a caper dinner. Or a barramundi fish with capers. Yum. I can't get enough capers. So we started with that. And I was really tempted. And now I'm trying to coerce my husband into going back. But I was really tempted to have the, yes, red velvet pancakes. I can't even stand how good that sounds. Are you guys bored? I'm sorry. I'm almost bored with myself today. I think what we'll do is I'll finish this up behind the scenes and come back and show you how it ends up, because this is just taking... The glue doesn't dry as fast as I would like. I've got that immediate gratification problem, and I, no matter how much I know that I need to, like, not, I'm not going to change. I need things done yesterday. All right, just to wrap up my story of the day, I did some great junking, so what I wanted to do is tempt you with my fashion files that I'm doing. You know, I do those episodes, my Bailey Minutes with clothing, and then I show you how to style it. Well, I got a lot of fabulous finds today doing that with my friend. I'm really feeling inspired with the clothes too, because I'm just, people really get it. They seem to understand the style that I'm creating and putting together. And it just encourages me to do more of that. So there's definitely going to be a lot of upcoming clothing episodes as well. I think I'm a little better at that than this. I'll get better at this, I promise. I think you'll be pleased, though, when I'm done. I can already tell it's coming together nice. I have to leave a little bit of slack so I can tuck those photos in. My idea is to put photos and then be able to remove them, but I might have to own the project and, like, actually glue them in. We'll see. All right, I'll come back with the finished version, but hope you have a great day, great evening, wherever you're at. Hi there, welcome back. I'm Brooke Ohana Bailey with the Bailey Minute, and I am doing a project, which those of you that know me, cross your fingers. Speaking of fingers, I've got glue gun all over my fingers. So here we are halfway. We're kind of at the halfway mark, but actually a little more than the halfway because it's going to get a little easier as it gets smaller. And I just wanted to show you folks how it's looking so far. I've got a little issue down here, but at least the glue is holding it. So we'll see. I'll be back in a minute to show you how it turns out, all right? I just thought you might want to see how it's looking so far so you get the gist of what we're doing. And I mean, I always do this. Jump ahead a little, I can't help myself, but hello, how cute is that? I'll see you soon. Hello, and we're back with the Bailey Minute, and I finally have the project finished, and I wanted to share it with you all, and Ophelia wanted to get her minute in to say hello to you all. Okay, you're free to go. All right, got to take off my apron, enjoy a glass of wine, and most importantly, enjoy this finished project. This is the lamp that I got today for $5. And this is what ended up, what it became. I'm gonna go ahead and turn it on. I was really pleased that it actually did work too. There you have it. So what I did was I added jute twine, and then I had this other rope that I finished it off. I did three on each corner. Pieces where I cut the length. I added little makeshift tassels. I had no plan, and it just kind of added and embellished as I went. And there is a fine line between over embellishing, so I didn't want to kind of cross that line. And I wanted it to have the ability to kind of interchange photos. So as you can see, you can remove or change up your look. So I kind of went with that. Like I told you before, I was doing sort of the ski, campy kind of feel. So this is great for that. And then you could also do even like a cool shell in there, like a flatter kind of shell. Or, oh my gosh, I'm going to have to show that now because that sounds really cute. So you can make it kind of a beachy lamp too. So a lot of variety. And I really like my projects to kind of convey that, like my ability to kind of chameleon change the look. So I have this whole plate of photos here where I could change it up. I've got some really fun group shots of people if I wanted to do that type of a theme. So anyway, a lot of fun. I really enjoyed the project. I was really happy with how it turned out, and I'll be pleased to have this in my shop someday. At least I'll have it in my house for a while. Thanks a lot. This has been the Bailey Minute with Brooke Ohana Bailey as your host. Have a good evening. Bye-bye.